in a Maratha family of Chingeri, and he was called a Vagh because he was called a Vagh, means the tiger. Why he was called as a tiger? Due to his bravery. And he started his career as a cavalry of soldier in Hyder Ali's army during Hyder Ali period. And he grew up in a position of military general. Down there, he built up his own private army and he fought along with Tipu Sultan. Because there was a difference between Dondeya and Tipu Sultan, so he fought to Tipu Sultan. And later, Dondeya was imprisoned by Tipu Sultan. And when this incident came to know to the British, the British are the people to release Dondeya from the prison, that is in 4th Anglo-Mysore War. And here, Dondeya, he built a small army and he started his operations. In essence, he started to give the training for the people, and he himself organized an army that made Tipu unhappy that Dondeya is against him. And later he captured two places. One is called Bidnore and Shivamugga forts, and it was an unsuccessful attempt that made by Dondeya, and he wanted to capture the Chitradurga fort, but he was unsuccessful. And in this, a British Governor General, Lord Wellesley, he is a person that he tried, he motivated Dondeya Vagh. And in this, an attack was organized to a place in Karnataka, that is called, there are the places like, an attack was organized, the places like Shivamugga, Honahalli, Harihara, and other places. And to bring under control of Dondeya, he lost his base. In the sense here, the places he made his army and all, no? So he lost Dondeya Vagh. And later, after that, he captured the places, the place like Shikaripura. And in this, Dondeya, he escaped to a place called Gutti, which was under the control of Nizama Hyderabad. When Nizam army attacked Gutti, and Dondeya from there also he escaped to the region of Maratha. And in this, the Maratha army attacked Dondeya and they captured horses, camels, arms, many more that came under Marathas here. Just this, Dondeya, he was just escaping from one place to another place. First Gutti, then again to Nizam of Hyderabad, and from there he just took a shelter that is under Maratha, and from there also he rescued. And in this, many Paligons were unhappy and they encouraged Dondeya Vagh. And in this, the French of Mahe, the Malabar region, that extended the support to Dondeya Vagh. And in this, the British army followed places like Harihara, Chitradurga, Shikaripura, Savanur, Ranibinur. The British army followed him, the vast area that include Harihara, Chitradurga, Shikaripura, Ranibinur, Kittur and Sharati. And in the Sharati, many followers of the Dondeya were killed, that is by Britishers. Now, how the life of Dondeya Vagh came to an end? Lord Wellesley, the British Governor General, he decided to end Dondeya Vagh. And in this, the British requested the help of local rulers. Dondeya, he again recaptured Shikaripura fort, and from there, scattered by the British army again. And here, the British tried to defeat the army of Dondeya, which was used to move, that is in between two rivers, that is Tungabhadra and Malaprabha. And there, the British attacked Dondeya from all the directions, and he followed still the place called Raichur. And he was caught in by the Maratha army and the Nizam army, and the British attacked him to a place called Yalaparvi and killed at Kunigal, that is to Dondeya Vagh. And with the defeat of the leader, the followers of Dondeya, they got scared, and the British captured arms and ammunition. Now let us study about the rebellion of Kittur, break when Chennamma, 1824. In this, the British brought many changes in the administration by defeating Marathas, Tipu Sultan and Hyder Ali. And here, a policy started. What was that policy? The policy was called the Doctrine of Lapse, introduced by Lord Dalhousie. Kittur lies between Dharwad and Belagavi. Can you observe, children, in Karnataka? That is to the north part. Mallasaraja. Chennamma, the queen of Mallasaraja, she took great interest in administrative matters and she started to rule the Kittur. After the death of Mallasaraja, his elder son, he was called Shivalinga Rudra Saraja. He took over the reign of Kittur, but Mallasaraja, due to his ill health, Chennamma has to take care day-to-day administration, and in the Shivalinga Saraja, he supported the British during Maratha War. And this resulted to enter to an agreement with Kittur and collected a payment from him. That is by Shivalinga Saraja. He has to pay a booty to the Britishers. And this agreement was entered during the time of Thomas Munro. Do you remember, children, this Thomas Munro? He is the person to implement Roythwari system. This also we studied in the impact of British rule in India. So this agreement was between the British and Shivalinga Saraj. Okay? Now, after the death of Shivalinga Rudra Saraj, Chennamma, she adopted a boy and she named the boy called Shivalingappa and started ruling Kittur. She was the queen of Kittur, and then a collector by name called Thackeray, a political agent of the British in Dharwad region. So he reported to the governor of Bombay and attempted to take over the Kittur kingdom, that is called the Doctrine of Lapse. Doctrine of Lapse, this was introduced by Lord Dalhousie. Lord Dalhousie, he came to India in the year 1848, a governor general of the British. He introduced this policy in India. So, policy, Doctrine of Lapse. Doctrine of Lapse is the policy. Adopted children have no rights to rule the kingdom. Only the natural heirs have the power to rule. Thackeray, he attempted to take over the treasury and the fort under his control. But Chennamma, she considered as a war, and she prepared for the war, and also British prepared themselves for the war. And in the battle, Thackeray was shot dead, and many British people and the many British army were taken as a prisoners during war in the period of Kitturani Chennamma. This was a war between the British, the first war. This is the second war between Kittur and the Britishers, and in this a collector, Thackeray was shot dead. After the death of Thackeray and many British people were in prisons, the prisoners, the British attacked Kittur again under the leadership of Colonel D. And in this, the army fought the battle very bravely, the Britishers. And here, Chennamma attempted to flee the battlefield, but she was captured by the British army. And she was imprisoned at a fort called Bailohangala. And Queen Chennamma, she passed away in the prison. And she still remained an idle person of Karnataka.